Good morning. I am Ruby with KFTV Dragon News.
Good morning. I'm Miguel. This is the sixth episode of Season 6 of KFTV Dragon News for the year.
We'd like to give a shout-out once again to Fikert's PTO.
That's right. Fikert's PTO, which stands for Parent Teacher Organization, puts on events and raises funds for our school.
Last October, they had a wonderful event called the Harvest Festival. They had inflatables, games, food, class baskets, and even a DJ.
It was a lot of fun. Kids and parents dressed up since Halloween was the very next week.
KFTV reporters were able to talk to a few people about the event. We had a lot of interviews.
We weren't able to show them all, but we've put it on our YouTube channel in case you want to look for yourself in the interview.
Here are a few that we can show you now.
Hi there. Can you tell me your name?
Hi, I'm Leo.
Hi. Who are you dressed up as?
A pilot.
It looks like you're holding the Titanic. Was that a big ship that sunk?
Yes.
Can you tell me, what's your teacher's name?
Mrs. Thomas.
Does that mean, are you a first grader?
Yes.
Fikert families and Fikert community, I am Sarah Johansson, the new PTO president, along with past PTO president Rochelle Yeager and past secretary April Schlegel. Can I say it right? Thank you so much. We had such a wonderful event. We had so many sponsors tonight for our fall festival this year. We had tons of games, 17 to 19 different games, inflatables, so much candy donation from Fikert families, and such an amazing time for our fall festival. So we thank you so much for everything, and we thank you for coming and enjoying the night with us and donating for all the raffle baskets and helping the teachers with funds for their classroom. All proceeds will go back to the teachers' room tonight. We are super excited. So thank you so much for everything that you have done.
An amazing DJ.
Oh, DJ was phenomenal. Yes.
Okay. What's your name?
Mrs. Fulcham.
And are you in a costume today?
I am dressed as a principal.
Okay, got it. It's a very good costume. And what's been your favorite game at the Fall Festival so far?
You know what? I have been in doing skee-ball for 2 hours, but I was over at the inflatable with the watching them do the basketball. That was so cool.
Yeah, I bet. All right, thank you.
Arlene. Natalie.
And who are you going to be for Halloween?
What are you going to be for
Halloween? A scary movie. I don't know.
Hi, I'm Miguel. What's your name?
Allison.
Allison, what's your costume?
A squirrel.
What's your favorite game at the festival so far?
The pirate ship race.
Okay, thank you. Your name?
Joanne.
Who are your kids here at Fikert?
So I have a son in fourth grade. His name is Benjamin Dominguez.
What's your experience at Fikert so far?
Well, we're new here, but so far it's been an excellent experience.
Okay, thank you.
All right, what are your names?
Katina.
Amaya.
And what are you guys supposed to be today?
She's Barbie, and I'm just Barbie's mom.
Okay, and what's your guys' favorite game so far?
I like at the carnival thing, scooping up the duck and seeing what I get.
Okay, got it. And so you made all this display?
Yes, I did.
All right, well, you did an amazing job. Thank you.
So your name?
Ben Dominguez.
What's your costume?
It's Michael Myers, or it could be Jason Voorhees.
Okay, what's your favorite game at the festival so far?
Probably the baseball one.
Thank you. Name?
Sophia Stone.
What's your costume?
I'm a snake.
Okay. What's your favorite game at the festival so far?
Miss Hoxson's duck hatching thing.
Okay. What's your name?
Rose.
And what are you supposed to be today?
A popular girl.
Okay. And what's been your favorite game at the Fall Festival so far?
Well, I haven't really played any games. I just played popcorn with my friends.
I got it. Thank you.
Reagan?
For the week of December 2nd through January 5th, we would like to say happy birthday to the following drive-ins.
Next up is weather. Today reporting the weather, we have Wafa Zara.
Hey Fiker Dragons, here's this week's weather forecast. The weather will be in the low 60s and the high 50s. There will be a small percent chance of rain and it will be partly cloudy, so make sure you have your sweaters. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks Wafa for reporting on the weather.
Do you like tea?
I've never really been a fan of tea, unless it has a lot of sugar in it. Why?
Well, not to brag, but I'm somewhat of a tea barista.
What's that?
Someone who makes tea. Let's check out to see my how-to, and I will teach you how to make a good cup of tea. Hello, today we'll be making tea. First, open the tea package. And the package will usually have instructions on the back. Today we'll be using a French press and a 7.5 milliliter spoon. Put the tea in the spoon and then put it in the French press. Next, get hot water either by boiling or a machine like I did. Next, put the lid on the French press and we'll set a 7-minute timer. Next, get your mug and pour the tea in the mug. Put the cap on and you have a freshly brewed cup of tea.
Okay, that makes me interested in giving it another try.
Well, good. Make sure to let us know what you think.
Okay, I'll keep you posted.
Next up, we have our Eston mystery. Let's see if you can figure out the final number.
Hi Fiker Dragons, here is this week's Eston Mystery. In this week's Eston Mystery, you will be guessing how many thumbtacks are in this jar. Make sure you change your estimate after each clue. Have fun!
Clue 1, the answer is an odd number.
Adjust your estimate.
Clue 2, the answer is between 50 and 120.
Clue 3, the answer is a prime number, which means the factors are only itself and one.
Think you've got it?
Clue 4. Two of the digits are the same number.
Clue 5. The last and final clue. The answer is included in a popular movie that features black and white dogs.
Get ready.
If you got 101 thumbtacks, then you are correct. Bye, dragons!
What do you know about sea turtles? KFTV's brand new reporter, Alessi, has researched some facts about the topic. Let's see what she has to say.
7 fun facts about turtles. Fact 1. Turtles don't have teeth. Fact 2. Turtles once shared the world with dinosaurs. Fact 3. Turtles have a long lifespan. Fact 4. Turtles never outgrow their shell. Fact 5. Turtles are cold-blooded reptiles. Fact 6. Sea turtles are stronger than humans. Fact 7. Turtles are the oldest reptile group in the world. Bye, dragons!
Thanks, Alessi. That was really interesting. Welcome to the KFTV Dragon News team.
Do you ever wonder what happened on this day in history? Well, I will tell you guys right now.
Welcome to this day in history. Did you know it's National Cupcake Day? Originally, cupcakes were called the 1, 2, 3, 4 cakes, or the number cakes. They were called this because all they needed was 1 cup of butter, 2 cups of sugar, 3 cups of flour, 4 eggs, 1 cup of milk, and 1 spoonful of baking soda. Cupcakes took their name from the cups they are baked in. Early cupcakes were baked in teacups or ramekins, small clay pots, before the invention of the multi-cup pans we use today. In 2012, 770 million cupcakes were eaten in the U.S. Cupcakes are called fairy cakes in Britain.
Thanks, Ruby. Winter break starts at 2:40 today. Let's see a short commercial about the actual dates of winter break.
Hey, Piker Dragons. Guess what's around the corner? Winter break, of course. Winter break is from the week of December 1st to the week of January 2nd. We will be returning back to school on January 3rd. Bye, dragons!
What are you doing for winter break?
I'm gonna spend time with my family. What about you?
I'm probably just gonna be asleep. Next up is Joke Box. Ready for some laughs? These jokes are even better than dad jokes, or worse.
What is the best breakfast cereal to eat in the winter?
What?
Frosted Flakes.
What do you call a snow skier?
What?
A snowpoke.
Oh, really?
What do you call a snowman a temper tantrum?
What?
A meltdown.
What did the tree say after a cold, long winter?
What
a relief.
How did the snow globe feel after listening to a scary story?
How?
A bit shaken up.
Oh. Back to you in the studio.
Later.
Next up, we have our baking segment.
Hi, I'm Ruby Quartz, and today I will be showing you how to make lemon cupcakes along with my trusty assistant,
Lincoln.
For this, you will need 2 lemons, baking powder, baking soda, flour, lemon juice, which is optional, butter, salt, 1 large bowl and 1 medium-sized bowl, a large whisk,
a zester for lemons, measuring spoons, measuring cups, sugar, egg whites, and buttermilk. First, you will put 2 cups of flour into your sifter if you have one. That wasn't on the list, but it's still good to use one to get out clumps. And then you will sift it into the bowl. Next, you will add 1 teaspoon of baking powder. Next, you will add 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. Next, you will add 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Then start whisking the ingredients together. In your large bowl, add 1 stick of butter. Next, add 1.5 cups of sugar. In your measuring cup, add egg whites. Next, add your lemon zest to the bowl. For this next step, you can either squeeze lemons by hand into the bowl, or you can add lemon juice. And then start mixing those ingredients. Next, alternate your dry ingredients and 2/3 cup buttermilk. Using two spoons, scoop your batter into the cupcake liners. So once your cupcake liners are filled, you will put them in the oven at 350 degrees Fahrenheit. For the whipped cream, you will need half a carton of heavy whipping cream, sugar, food coloring, green one, vanilla extract, sprinkles, which are optional, scissors, and a piping bag. Oh, and piping tips. First, pour your cream into a bowl. Next, add 1 teaspoon of your vanilla extract into the bowl. Start off with a half a cup of sugar, but add more if you want it sweeter. Whip until your cream has stiff peaks. Don't forget to add the food coloring. Next, scoop your whipped cream into the piping bag. The cupcakes are out of the oven. Time to decorate now. And that's how you make lemon cupcakes. Back to you guys in the studio.
That wraps up the news for today.
And let's have a nice break. And remember, dragons are kind,
safe,
and responsible.
This is KFTV Dragon News signing off.